Hello everyone. In the previous video lecture, we have understood about how to build a model in Simulink, and an example we have taken is first part of our experiment 1, that is NRZ polar signaling. Now in this video I am going to explain you how to simulate RZ coding using MATLAB Simulink. So here is the block diagram. I assume that you have seen the first video, then only you will be able to understand this one, as I am directly going to explain the configuration and the waveforms. Okay, so this is the block diagram, same has been represented over here. Once we choose for the particular blocks, we need to configure them. So the configuration is given in the procedure. As you can see, this is the procedure. That is, first four steps include the interconnection of blocks. Then in the second step, what we have is double click on pulse generator to set amplitude 1, period 1 second, pulse width 50%. So here amplitude is 1, period is 1, pulse width is 50% already. So I hope no need to change this one. Then another pulse generator, it is also set at the same values, and all other blocks are remain unchanged. Okay, so let me run the model. So these are the waveforms we are going to get when we simulate the block diagram. The first waveform is data sequence, which is generated by Bernoulli's binary generator, and it is nothing but unipolar NRZ signal. So this signal we are giving as an input, so as to generate what? Unipolar RZ and polar RZ. So let us examine the signals whether they are correct or not. As from the definition you know that unipolar RZ will be present for half the bit interval, that is, if there is a bit 1, it will be present for first half of the bit interval, next half it will returns to 0. As you can see, the duration here is large, and this duration of the pulse, that is unipolar RZ, is half of the input pulse. Same is true here. Here you can see there are 3 bits of information, but the 3 bits are here having returning to 0 after half of the bit interval elapses. Same is true with the other bits. Okay, then coming to polar RZ, you can see that zeros were earlier represented by 0 voltage level. Now zeros are represented by negative voltage level for half of the bit interval. After that, the zeros will return to 0 voltage level. Correct? So plus 1 representing bit 1 for half of the bit interval, minus 1 voltage level will represent bit 0 for first half of the bit interval. After that, signal returns to 0. That's why these signaling formats are called as return to 0 signaling formats. So one is unipolar return to 0 signal, another one is polar return to 0 signal. I hope you have understood how to simulate this particular model. Now we have understood NRZ unipolar, that is directly generated from the Bernoulli's binary, then NRZ polar and RZ unipolar, RZ polar. So these four waveforms we have generated using MATLAB Simulink. So these are the line codes already you know, correct? Apart from that, in this particular experiment, we are going to generate another two kinds of pulses known as half sinusoid, which you can see in the figure, and raised cosine pulse. These two pulses we are generating using the MATLAB code. Okay, the generation of these half sinusoid and raised cosine pulses we will see in our next video. थैंक यू।